By phone from the scene of the accident is Senator Jeff Flake. Senator, tell me what you experienced when the accident occurred, and I know you were involved in rescuing some of the injured on the truck.
No, I was near the front of the train, sitting with my wife and son, and we felt a big impact. Obviously, everybody was thrown around a bit, but I don't think anybody on the train is seriously injured. But I worked my way back about 10 cars parallel to the accident. As I could see, as I looked out the window as we went by the truck that had been hit. And then there was one deceased who they worked on for quite a while I was there, and we were tending to the other injured person. And it was myself and Senator Cassidy and Congressman Winstrup and a few others. And we bolted him on a stretcher and then carried him to the ambulance eventually.
Senator, I should ask you, how old is your son, and is your son okay, and your wife?
Oh, yes, he's fine. He's 18, and my wife was thrown around a bit, but nobody on the train that I know of was injured seriously. Some were shaken up, but obviously a terrible scene outside of the train.
Now, you said you were in one of the front cars, but that you worked your way 10 cars back to the point of impact. Does that mean that the train hit the truck, not with the front car, or maybe you can explain
better
to me?
It hit with the front car, and the front car is derailed, actually. So we're going to have to unhook from the derailed front car. That's my understanding. But it took a while for the train to stop. I could see as we went by, I was about 4 cars back, the truck that we hit. And so I knew there were going to be bad injuries. So I worked my way back thinking they might need somebody to help carry people to an ambulance or whatever, and they did.
And, Senator, how fast, can you estimate how fast the train was going when it at the point of impact?
I don't. It was, I mean, we were probably at as high a speed as we go in the, you know, in this area. So I don't know what that would be, 55, 60 miles an hour. I'm not sure, but we were going in a good clip, and it was a hard impact that obviously smashed the truck pretty badly. I'm assuming that there were 3 people in the truck or on the truck. I'm assuming the 2 that were ejected, the one that we were working on and the deceased were, I'm assuming they were on the back of the truck, and the person who was in the cab actually was able to walk with assistance to an ambulance. So that person fared the best. The other 2, it's pretty tough. The injuries are very serious to the one that was that we carried to the ambulance.
And from what you witnessed, at what point did the train hit the truck, or we're looking at the pictures now. It's hard to tell exactly.
You know,
what
we
part
don't
of the
know
truck
exactly,
was.
But I'm looking at the cab of the truck right now. I'm assuming that that it was hit behind the cab, and that the one that was left injured was in the cab. You could see how somebody could survive in the cab. If the other 2 were on the back of the truck, which typically is routine for a garbage truck like this, then they were ejected from it, and they probably felt a lot of the full impact.
From your observation, was the person, was the passenger on the truck who died, was that person alive when you were there?
No, I don't think. I got back pretty quickly, and they were doing CPR by that point, but I don't think that he was ever conscious. That's my assumption, but they worked on him for quite a while, tried everything with the paddles, and but he, I don't think, ever came to.
And I assume there were Capitol Police and other security, with the speaker being on the train, that there are plenty of people there to take care of everyone.
Yeah, there were. And a few of the doctors, they were asking for doctors. And Dr. Cassidy, Senator Cassidy, got off quickly, and so did Brad Winstrup. And as we're working on the injured, just remembering it was Brad and I that were with Steve Scalise.
I was going to ask you about that.
Similar thing. Brad was cutting away the coat so they could attach some of the equipment that is very, very similar to what we're doing, cutting away the clothing so we could apply the tourniquet. So it was too familiar.
I was going to ask you about that because you had, you know, such an horrific incident on that baseball field, the softball field, and Steve Scalise, of course, was paid tribute to on the floor last night.
Right.
It was quite a moment.
Yeah.
I know you were there.
It was. Yes.
How are you doing?
Thank you.
You've been through two traumas that we know of this year.
I am very, very happy to be okay. I'm fine. And I just hope that the two injured survived.
And are you planning, do you know, is there a plan to bus you all to White Sulphur Springs for important meeting?
The last I heard, we have to pull back from the derailed engine. We have an engine at the back of the truck, or the train, so we can do that. And I believe they're taking us to some buses where we'll go the rest of the way. That's my understanding right now.
But you're still on the train right now?
Yes, I just climbed back on. Yeah.
Well, we want to thank you for your patience and time in talking to us today and for everything you did to try to rescue victims, and wish you some rest and quiet with your family. I know this is a very tough time. Thank you for being with us,
thank
Senator
you.
Jeff Flake.
Hey there, I'm Chris Hayes from MSNBC. Thanks for watching MSNBC on YouTube. If you want to keep up to date with the videos we're putting out, you can click subscribe just below me or click over on this list to see lots of other great videos.